Good morning, YouTube. So, time to replace this BuildTak sheet. This is on the FlexPlate. I don't know if you can see all the wrinkles there, but it's basically started peeling up and I've got a few tears right along there. I got about 6 months of use out of that sheet of BuildTak. I think I put it in early February. And it's now early August, so that's a pretty good time. And you can see down here, right at the start, I forgot to disable the purge strip. So that's where the printer, when you first start a print, it would normally come over here and lay down about that much filament. I finally figured out that setting is saved in your profile. Once you change this start G-code, I showed you that in an earlier video, you need to save that profile, and then every time you start up Cura, you've got to reload the profile that has the filament printing temperature, but it also has this purge pass commented out. Because if you don't do that, it'll start printing there. And this one wore out just in a week or so before I realized that I had lost that setting. So that's the only thing I'm not sure about, is exactly how to get this off of the flex plate without damaging it. So I guess it comes up pretty easy. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, that comes off nice. Yeah, there's very little residue. So it starts out easy here. And then it just gets harder and harder. But the thing you have to watch for is that you don't bend the thin metal. So you kind of work your way around. Yeah, I might have to heat this up a little bit. Yeah, so this seems to work pretty good, kind of running your heat gun along here. And then that section comes up a little bit easier. Just have to wear gloves when you're doing that. Let's see now. Yeah, you can get about an inch at a time before it kind of sets up again. Do all four corners, and then you can come in here in the middle sections. So I've got all four corners peeled up, and now what I do is go in to the little triangle between the corners. So I'll come in here and heat up this area. Now we can get in there. You got to put one hand down on the metal and then you pull back here. And you can see now it's starting to get hard right there. That's where I heated. So then you move around, put this side up on top, and repeat the process. So I'll show you what it looks like when I get done here. Okay, finally got the last bit peeled off there. So yeah, you can see how wrinkled up that BuildTak was on the bottom there. So now the trick is you got to get all the adhesive residue off. So I have myself some acetone, and I'll go grab a couple paper towels. And what I did is, this is a pizza stone out of my oven. I put that down to protect the countertop from the heat gun. Okay, we got the flex plate cleaned off, and what I found actually works pretty well for this. I did this on the Garolite plate too, is I just laid the edge of the BuildTak sheet right up vertical against the edge of the flex plate, and then just rolled it over with just a little bit of the paper peeled back, and that lets me get the edge down there. And then I'll just gradually pull this backing sheet off and then smooth it out as I go across. So actually I think it's easier putting this on this than on the thick heated glass build plate. That just leaves the edge just very slightly hanging over there, just a bare minimum, and I think it's lined up pretty good across there. So then we'll get the rest of that on there and I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, YouTube, looks like the BuildTak is working here. Put the sheet back in and we're just doing a test print here. So I just want to make sure the bed temperature is proper. I have it, I started out, I used to use 100°C, now I'm using 95, and it looks like that's adhering pretty good. This is black ABS I'm printing with, and I just changed filament too, so I'm also checking the extrusion multiplier. So this is my favorite little test piece to do that. It doesn't take very long to print, and I can just verify that everything is sticking to the BuildTak and that I've got the extruder and extrusion multiplier set right. So this printing 250°C on the filament, 0.6mm nozzle, and then I've got the BuildTak FlexPlate at 95°C. I don't see the part warping or anything yet, so that's good. Yep, there we go. Like a little stringing there. Yeah, usually for smaller parts like this, I won't pull the flex plate out because I find that thin, small parts don't really flex off. You have to have a big enough part that's stiff so that you can flex the plate and have it pop off. Something this thin is just going to bend with the flex plate. Although usually I let these cool a little bit before I take them off. I just want to see. Yeah, that came up pretty good. There's the bottom. And then I like to check the ends. Make sure the ends and the top, make sure the extrusion is full. Looks like it's pretty good there. Yeah, I think that's good to go. I don't know if there's a difference in the color, because I noticed the black seemed to be a little stickier or a little more adhesion on the parts than the white. With the white, I had to start out at 100°C and then I moved it down to 95. Now I'm at 95 and this is sticking okay. So looks like it's good to go though. Got the BuildTak replaced, got some new filament back there. We're ready to do another run of parts. I got a couple orders came in this morning, so I need to get this thing running. So yeah, I just wanted to give you a update on the BuildTak. So the last sheet lasted right at 6 months. That's how you change out the BuildTak flex plate. So I think if I were to describe it, it's a little harder to remove the BuildTak from the flex plate because you have to worry about bending this. When I was on the original heated build plate here, which is the aluminum base and then the heater and then the glass, you didn't have to worry about that. That piece would stay perfectly flat and rigid, but you had to take this piece out. You had to disconnect the heater cable down below and then remove the build plate from the supports, and then when you were done you had to put it back in and re-level everything. I haven't touched anything. I took this out, replaced the BuildTak, and I put it back in. I didn't have to re-level the base. I think overall it's about the same amount of time, just a little more tedious to get this off of the flex plate because you do not want to bend that. If you bend it, it's pretty much shot because since it's a spring steel, if it does bend, it's going to be a hard kink. It won't be a soft kind of curve. But yeah, definitely that set down flat. I don't see any bending at all. It's nice and flat still. Yeah, so if you have any questions about the BuildTak or the flex plate, post up in the comment section down below there. I'll put some other videos over here on the left side you might be interested in. And as always, thanks for watching.